this is Approved of God coming to you once more.
Hello. Is it me you're looking for? I can see it in your eyes. I can see it in your smile.
Now, I have a serious question for those of you who believe you're Trinitarians and that you believe that the Trinity is really who God is. Now, the question is very serious, and you should consider it, because one day we're going to stand before God in judgment, and He will judge us for all the false teachings that we not only believe, but that we promoted. Now, why is it that the Bible speaks about the Creator in a singular person? Why is it that wherever the word Creator is mentioned, it's only a singular being, a singular person? It's never a reference to a Trinity.
In Isaiah 54:5, we read something that is commonly overlooked by readers of the English Bibles. We must remember that Western translations, like English, do not translate correctly when it comes to singular nouns versus plural ones from the Hebrew. Let's look at Isaiah 54 verse 5 as an example of this mistranslation. For your Maker is your husband, the Lord of hosts is his name, and the Holy One of Israel is your Redeemer. The God of the whole earth he is called. As you can read, most modern translations have maker and husband as singular. For your makers are your husbands. Jehovah of hosts is their name. And your Redeemer is the Holy One of Israel. He is called the Elohim of all the earth. Maker and husband, as singular. The Hebrew, however, does not use them as a singular, but as a plural. Hebrew Roots Bible got it right when translating this passage from the Hebrew. Isaiah correctly understood the plural manifestation of Yehovah written about in the Torah of Moses. You also have this same type of language of makers and creators from other writings in the Hebrew Bible outside of the prophets. Psalm 149:2. Let Israel rejoice in his makers. Let the sons of Zion be joyful in their kings. Ecclesiastes 12:1. Remember now your creators in the days of your youth. While the evil days do not come, or the year strike, when you shall say, I have no pleasure in